Got him picked. Barrera breaking. Lost the ball. Still picks it up and makes the tag. Got it out of his glove. Caught it on a hop off the turf. And they get the pickoff. Short lead again for Humphrey. And this one flared out into center field. A diving grab there by Tanner Williams. Nice job. Had to go along. Gillenwater making his fourth start of the season. 3-for-11 at the plate. 273. No homers and two RBIs. That'll go down the first base line as Myers, the first baseman, playing off of it. Big turn by Gillenwater, but give some credit to Matt Dillon for a bit of hustle out in right field. He got over there and limits Gillenwater to his... Through the left side and the ball get through. Green light for Gillenwater. He'll round third and the ball bobbled by Hall, the left fielder. The throw into second will be in time. No, they missed the tag. So it'll be a single for Barrera. RBI for towards right. Playable. Dillon on the run will let that drop. Makes a grab on a high turf hop. Hatch sliding at second. Kept the foot on the bag. He almost overslid it. And in all that, Barrera comes in to score. And it's 2-0. And gets into chase again. It'll fall off to the right. The pitch winds up going. The 1-1. Fly ball to left. Hatch will come in. Continues to charge in. And makes the catch to retire the side. And close out the game. As the Cavaliers get their first complete game from a pitcher this year. A two-hitter at Hilken Community Stadium where the Cavaliers win game two of today's doubleheader, and Coach Rob Vance with us here. And I know the split, not what you wanted, of course, going in, but I have to say, two good starting performances from your pitchers today, including one from a freshman who hadn't started for you before.
Yeah, I was pretty pleased. You know, I never like losing, but I thought we competed really well all day, and I thought we pitched well all day. So, you know, moving forward, that it's still early season. We have such a short preseason. We're still learning things about our guys a little bit. And I think we found out something about a freshman. The left-hander in game two there, we were pretty sure we were going to get a good one.
Were you sure you were going to get seven innings and two hits? That was a pretty strong performance.
We weren't sure we were going to get that. He's a really tough kid. You know, he pitched in junior college quite a bit for a team that won a title. So he's used to pitching in what we would call big games. And, I mean, in GNEC conference play, every game's a big game because you just never know what's going to happen.
Is he the type of guy that, again, you're going to be able to alternate as you did in this series between the field one day and pitching another?
Yeah, he did it in junior college, and that's the reason we're starting him in game four, is so that he can play the field in either one, two, or three games and then go on the mound. I was able to get him out and sit him in game one so we didn't have to go today, but that's not always going to be the case.
Talk a little bit about your freshman in game one. It seemed like it was going on just a situation of him running out of gas there in the sixth a little bit.
I think so. You know, he hasn't started. We've been training him kind of in long relief, but his relief appearances so far this year have been, I think the most was four innings. And so we kind of knew he was going to get stretched a little bit, you know, and he just getting ran out of gas at, I don't know, what, fifth or sixth inning.
Yeah, in the sixth finally.
Yeah, and walked a couple of guys, which hurt us a little bit. But, you know, we thought we were going to get good things from him. He played for a really good program in Southern California, and so he's used to pitching against really good hitters and those kind of things. So we figured he would settle in pretty well.
How do you take that now? Give us a little coaching insight as the season continues to go along, as the weather gets a little bit warmer, as you get more innings in an arm and so on. How do you develop that into longer and longer starts?
You know, the way our schedule works, it's tough because they really only can throw once a week. And since he got stretched today a little bit, he'll go light. But, you know, we talked to him about being efficient. He's got to walk less guys, and that'll keep him in the game longer.
Sure.
But other than that, you know, we try and do some other things conditioning-wise to hopefully build up some stamina, not just throwing. But, you know, keep lifting and keep running and those kind of things that the bodies hopefully can handle a little bit more stress down the road.
In the past, you've had some pitchers who have handled that second game, that seven-inning game rather well, become the master of it. Do you intentionally look as a coach for a guy who's built or developed or used to or whatever you want to put it to go a nine and a guy who's used to going to seven? Do you start to pencil guys in for seven inning starters?
Absolutely. And what we're hoping is that we don't have to use the bullpen in those games.
Yeah.
You know, game four is a little different when we know who's available. Game two on Saturday, you know, we're hoping we get a guy who's going to go seven. It's not always going to happen, but we're looking for those kind of guys in those games. You know, we've had some guys in the past that probably should have started game one, but we put them in game two so that we wouldn't have to use the bullpen.
I know you'd like to get more than two runs in a doubleheader, but you earned a split out of it nevertheless. What are you starting to see in the offense and the bats? Where do you need to go from here to get some more on the board?
We got a ways to go offensively, but it's progress. You know, we worked really hard this week. We knew you were going to see a couple of left-handers, so we worked really hard this week on the approach. We've got some guys coming around. Bavakwa's starting to come back around a little bit. The other guys, it's just going to take a little bit of time. And again, it's one of those things, you know, you can inter-squad scrimmage as much as you want in January, but until you start playing other teams, we really don't know what guys are going to look like. So now that we've got 4 weekends in, we kind of know what we need to work on a little bit. We saw, I mean, this is pretty typical GNAC pitching, a lot of off-speed pitches. They'll have a guy here and there who can really run it up like Cox yesterday.
Yeah.
And so, and now we can get a little more focused on what we need to work on as far as our own hitters.
For your more experienced guys like a Bavakwa or a Crosby coming around, is it a self-confidence thing? Is it just trips to the plate against somebody else's arms? What starts to turn the tide?
I think it's a little of both. You know, with Mitchell, it's definitely confidence. You know, he was out for a couple of weeks in the preseason. Timing was a little off. And then he started pressing. You know, he started out 0 for 7 or something like that.
Yeah.
Of course, all he's thinking about is getting a hit, like a normal hitter. So I think with him, it's definitely confidence. With the other guys, every guy's so different. It's plate appearances and hopefully having some success.
Go on the road for the next couple of weekends. Talk a little bit about next weekend at Central Washington. What do you look for there?
It's going to be a good series. You know, it's tough to go over there and play. The weather could be very difficult to play in. I've heard it's pretty cold and they still have some snow, so we'll wait and see what happens. But, you know, in our conference, because of the travel, anytime you go on the road, it's going to be a tough weekend. It's great to be at home, but we got to go on the road and play well. Hopefully the preseason helped us kind of prepare for that a little bit, being gone for almost a month. So, you know, I looked last night, Central, they won twice yesterday. They're going to have a good club and it'll be a really good test for us.
Right now, fair to say for your club, more a do our own thing, take care of our own things rather than looking so much at the opponent and what you might have to do in situations against them?
Definitely. Definitely. We're going to have to play our game. You know, our team is built to play at this park. We're not going to hit a lot of home runs. We hopefully will play good defense, which we did today.
Yeah.
And so we really try not to focus too much on the other team. We'd like to know some tendencies. We like to know the big hitters, you know, who the big arms are, those kind of things. But other than that, we prepare to play our game, and hopefully we can take that with us no matter where we are.
Well, hopefully there will not be too many snow drifts to race through in Ellensburg, and you go there and then on the road at Northwest Nazarene the weekend after that. So we'll wish you safe travels, and then see you back here in a couple weeks for night game with UBC.
Yes, sir, that should be fun. Haven't seen those guys in a couple years. It's a different coach, but I know him a little bit, and it's fun to play those guys. It'll be a good baseball game.
All right, thank you for the time. Appreciate it. Congratulations. Nice way to end the series, picking up the win there and some great pitching.
So. Yes, it is. Thank you.
Rob Vance with us here. And we will wrap things up from Hilken Stadium. The Cavaliers lose the opener in today's doubleheader to the Montana State Billings Yellow Jackets 4-0, but they come back in the nightcap with a complete game win for Trevor Huddleston as he goes the distance. And by the way, we get the first exclusive in a long while here on the Cavaliers Sports Network as Joe Danahay has revealed that Trevor Huddleston will be tomorrow's